Hello creative designers and welcome on to this studio. My name is Peter. Head on to this studio. We're just going to see on this plugin which is called notification custom notification that for WordPress. I just came across this plugin. It's a good plugin. The plugin is just helping us, just helping you as admin or whatever who you are on your website to just give the notification to the subscribers or the customer or whoever needs the notification. It has so many type of notification. Here you have just a few of them. It has the welcome email, and this welcome email will just happen whenever you have a new registration. The one who registered will get a notification, an email. It has this option that we can be able to edit this email. It has a shortcode. You can just be able to paste. Here you have the message to be shown. It has all that. I'm just going to show you how you customize that. It has so many of them. It has comment, reply, new registration for admin, new registration for user, request, password or lost password, and post a password reset link, and comment with moderation. And for the subscribers, this is a free plugin. It has so many features are available. I'm just going to show you how we can be able to set up. We're going to set up maybe one or two and see how we can be able to do it. The type of notification, it allow the email notification. It just deliver that email to the one it just without you being there to type the message or you being there to trigger the message to be sent. It will just do all that automatic. The only thing you just need to do is you have a SMTP plugin which will just allow the website to send email. That's the tutorial for today. I hope it will be good for you. If you haven't subscribed to this YouTube channel, hit the thumbs up. Remember to subscribe if you're new. And without further ado, let's just get into action and I'll show you how. So the first thing we just need to do, we need to get the dashboard. And if you have not watched my previous tutorial, I did a tutorial on how to customize the dashboard. You can see how this look like. Just look like amazing. It doesn't pop up on hover. It just have so many features you can check. I'll include the link on the description on how you can be able to customize your dashboard all for free with a free plugin. So with that, let's now get to today's tutorial. The first thing you just need to do, we need to go to the dashboard menu, scroll to here, you have the plugin. And on hover, we just need to install a new plugin. So on hover, we have these three options. Select the second option because we need to install a new free plugin. The plugin is called Notification Custom Notification and Alert for WordPress. It's a free plugin. And with that, here we have it is called Notification Custom Notification Alert. For WordPress is from Blacketspace. It has more than 10,000 active installation. You can see out of 104, those people who have rated this plugin has given it a 4.5 star. Last updated just 7 days ago since the day I'm doing this tutorial. So what you just need to do, we install the plugin. After successful installation, we activate the plugin. For now, the plugin has been activated. We have now on the dashboard menu, we have now this button for the notification, and on hover, you see we have this menu here. If we have created some notification, you can click on this notification button here and you'll be able to see all the notification that you have activated. If you haven't and you want to add this on hover, you have this plus button. You can just click on it and to be just added, and you can click one notification. All else you can go to the wizard and set up everything. So from there, we have a new notification. You can just create one from scratch, and in which we are going to do in this tutorial. So the first thing we just need to do, once you just select a new, you just need to select whatever you just want to create. So before you proceed there, let's first of all go to extension and see that extension that are available for this plugin. It doesn't show up notifications. I don't know why. So let's go to setting and see if it's one major setting we just need to set before we proceed. So it seems like we need first of all to go to the wizard. So you can just keep the wizard here. So now you can have button there. It's now good. Once you have skipped the notification, you can be able to create one, and you see, it's so easy. and you have the extension. Let's see. Yeah, but most of these you just need to purchase them, but I don't really think we just need them for now. Let's go to the setting. Yeah, for the setting, yeah, we just leave it. You can just learn the wizard. You can allow the background processing by WC cron with this. That means that once everything is done, it just takes some few minutes, and this WP cron will just trigger it after a jet feed view. Yeah, this most of them, it is just is very helpful to some in some situation. So installation, I want to just try to install the plugin. So many things that are going to be removed, you can just take all this. So from there we have the triggers. You can set for the triggers. I think you're going to go on that on the other end. So let's now start on, we add a new notification here. So we just need to give it a name. So let me say a welcome email like that. The thing is that we need to add up the trigger. After just give it a name, we now need to set up the trigger. What will trigger this email to be sent? So you just need to come here. There's so many features. There's so many which are available here, but the one I just need is the user registration. You have the user registration for new account. I select this one. From there, now we need to add the carrier. The carrier is that which mode of delivery do you want? I want to use for email. With that, now we need to set up the email. So we need to get a bit header and just need to add some few the content in the body, and we can add. So we're going to do that. So let's just give the email the subhead, the subject. So we call the email welcome to. You can give it your email, your website name. So I can say welcome to thiarara.co.ke. With that, now we can come here and we add the email. So whatever the email is just going to create, there are a few guidance that are going to help us. We have the date. You can use this shortcut to add the date function here. We have for the user, all these are for users, and we have for custom field. This can change depending on the feature that you have just selected here. If we just come back here and just select another one here, so you can see it has author, and it has so many shortcuts for author, and it has date, and you can see page modification, date time, and all that. Last edited, it has so many features. Depending on whatever the trigger you have just selected here, it may it always make it alter this shortcut here. So I'm just going to get back here, and I say it's a user registration. Once I just turn it off, yeah, it should show that. So yeah, I say Hody. So I'm just going to say the username. So the username is the, I can say user ID is the username. It will present the username. I enter the shortcode and I add a comma here, and I just get back here and I just give just a small brief message to just welcome my new user who has registered to my website. So I say welcome to welcome to the community and all that. Let's just leave you the simple message I've just created. So I just say Hode user ID, which is this one. That means that the username, that the username, and I say welcome to my website. I can just and link this one to something different. Then I just say to set your password, use the shortcut here, and I paste it here. This will just provide a link to reset the password. And I also say, and if you want to log in to your dashboard, use this user login here. And just that, I just conclude with just regards and my name. With that, now I think that is just very simple welcome message for us. So there is now who is there to receive the message. So we say the recipient is the user email, like that. So with that, I think we are good to go. You can add another recipient, maybe an admin, and you say administrator, and administrator email should automatically here, or else you can be able to change it. So that's how it works. So from there, all other this is when you just want to install conditions. For extension, you need a provision for that part. That all you just need to do is you save. And make sure if you want to use it instantly, make sure this button is turned on like that. So from there, we can be able to go back to the notifications here and be able to see the one we have just created is for user registration and email. That for you to be able to also send email, you just need this plugin here. If you find an error on email, we have easy SMTP. I have a tutorial. I include the link in the description to just help you to just allow your website to send email to direct to the inbox. Sometimes you find that the message secured website are sent to the spam. So from there, if you just want to create all this email at once, all you just need to do, let's go, I think it's the setting here, and we learn the wizard, and all we just need to do is we select all of them here, the one you just want to use, yeah, like that. Just that we create the 13 notifications. With that, we have just been able to create all those notifications just by click. You see, we have so many of them here. So we have the one for admin. If you don't want the one for admin, if you're the one, just click on it, just turn it off. And you can see you have the user registration for admin and for the users. Just so many features you can also check. We have even the welcome email, the one you just created. With that, I think we have been able to create. Let me try to figure out. Let me just add a new user here. So we have now the two users that are available now. We can be able to create. So just come back here, save. And I can just open this in a private tab. So I just copy that and I just open it in a private window or incognito window. I just paste it and you just try to log in. So let's see how it works. So you have even my account. So let's say we just want to edit our password, or else I just log out here and I just say, I just remove this one here. And I say I lost my password username, and let me just add, and I'll send the password here. Let's try to see if it works. So yeah, let me open and check my email. So here you see the first email we just created here. So you see it, the one is for the password request. It is, hi, I know someone requested for a new password for an account. Yeah, and the username here. And if the request just, if you didn't make the request, just ignore. And if you just click here, you can be able to change it. I have another one here, which says someone requested for, and stay the same. And that's how it works to have these. And you can see we have the link, hold on, click on this. You can be able to change the password so easily. And from there, yeah, here we have it. So let me just cruise back here and I come back here and I show you something. We have now this email, so which says welcome to Thiarara.co.uk. Remember, we did create this one, and to reset your password use this link and log into your dashboard, admin one. So this is the user and not that. So it just did all we just needed. It works very well. The emails are being sent clearly. So the one it did just is for lost password. So this one here, and you can see we can try to relate with whatever you have just seen and see if it works. Someone requested for your password for in site title, username, and all that. If you're mistake, just like if you said just use the following link. It works very well. And I hope you did learn something out of this tutorial. The other thing is, now we can go back here. There are a few things here we never set. So I need to go to the notification and I go to setting. And on the setting, now here we have the general one. Is the one we have. We just leave it to it. So now we have the trigger. What are those? The one that you just. So what are these post types that that can trigger the email to be sent? So you can come back here and I just need to remove for that and say just for post. And we have the taxonomy. I'm not going to leave any notification for taxonomy for the comment. Yeah, type of comment. Yeah, we have do not send notification. Yeah, if you have a Kim's met installed, if the Kim's met just do any change on the comment, it would not show the notification. Now on user, you can enable for users media triggers, no themes, no plugins, no maybe for WordPress and all that. You can just check on that. Those are whatever you just want the notification to be triggered for. From there, now you have the carriers. Enable carriers, yeah. And I was to enable, maybe let me use HTML and that. You can add from, you can just leave it from WordPress, because the one you just received here add this label for WordPress. You can see it has these labels for WordPress here and here. So you can just change, for you to change is just come here and copy your website address here and just paste it here. Add your email here and all that. Allow to configure email header, yeah, sure. And with that, just save the changes. So from there, we now get to the integration. So default, you can disable some emails here from there. If you don't want someone to be emailed when the password is changed, just click on this. You can just select those you just want to. I don't think we just need have any more. We just can be able to set for this plugin. You can just get it, try and work for much better. If you have any other option, you can just come and just leave it into my comment section. I'll get into it. If you have any tutorial you're missing out on this channel, give it to the comment section. And if you like this tutorial, hit the thumbs up. If you're new here to this YouTube channel, remember to subscribe. Till next time. Thank you. Hope you did learn something.